So I have seen another question like if all the suppose in inheritance, if all the classes have the same method, for example, in this program, what I have did is I have created a method called get detail GF, then get detail F, and the get detail S like that. What happens if you use the same thing like get detail here and get detail here? What it will do is it will print only the content in the derived class. For example, assuming I use only detail, okay? Assuming I am using only detail and I am printing the get detail, okay? So I am creating the object for son S, and I am just printing the get detail and assuming that I will get this GF code, F code and S code like that. So now if you execute this, what you will get is you will get only the content in the derived class. So you'll get only the code for sun, S code. The reason is when we have the same method in both and derived class, the derived class will override the property of the base class. That means this S code will override the F code and G code, and you will get only S code as the result. And this concept is called as method overriding, and we will see that later in our topic. Like here, we will see method overriding, and we will see what are all the ways in which we can control this method overriding and all. Okay, so at this point, let me stick with this inheritance. So I will just change everything as it is. So assuming I use different method name, okay. So any doubt in this multi-level inheritance? Any doubt? Any doubt? We'll proceed with the next topic, or if you have any doubt, maybe we can discuss for some 2 minutes or 3 minutes. Yeah, the question is all programs using like if I want to print like get de if I use get detail as a method for everything, and what it will happen is the derived class will override the property of the base class, and to overcome that we will use something called dynamic dispatch method, and we'll see that. So using dynamic dispatch method we can print everything even though if it has the same method name. So that we will see that later in the class. Okay. So we'll go for the next topic. So the next topic is hierarchical inheritance. And what I have said is the hybrid inheritance is possible, but when you create a hybrid inheritance, when it comes like when the outcome is like multiple inheritance, it won't supported in Java. So now we'll just focus on hierarchical inheritance, then we'll go for some hybrid inheritance. So now this is said to be a multi-level inheritance. Now I'm going to delete this. So now what I'm going to do is like, so we have like this kind of general base class. And we have something like derived class like this. It's like a hierarchical tree. And or in common, if you have a single base class with so many derived class, then it is said to be a hierarchical inheritance. Assuming, for example, consider this as college. consider this as department, consider this as office, consider this as like placement cell, and consider this as exam cell, like that. So again, we can have the extension, like we can have CSE. We can have something called CSE. Then we can have something called MEC, like that. So this level of inheritance is said to be hierarchical inheritance. It's like a tree structure where the college is the topmost base class, and it should be like the form, or the form, it will be like this. So we can provide a relationship between like this, like college is a base class, department is an intermediate class, and CSE is a derived class, like that. Or we can take like this also, college is a base class, then department is an intermediate class, and MEC is a derived class, like that. So we can have like a multi-level kind of inheritance in hierarchical also. So here we can have again like department is a base class for CSE and MEC, and like college is the base class for everything, like that. So this kind of inheritance is called as multi-level inheritance. It's like hierarchical inheritance. So it's a hierarchical inheritance, is nothing but it's a tree-based, tree-like structured inheritance. So normally many programmers, many people, they will use this kind of inheritance so that they will structure everything in a proper format, and they will do that. Okay, so let me write a program for it. So I'm going to create something called class college, then class. So I'm going to write a program for this one. So to demonstrate this thing, class department, then I can have class office, like that, then class CSE, then class MEC. Then I can have a main method, class hierarchical demo. So then I will have a public static void main string args, like that. So now what I'm going to do is, now this, you can see this department is extending college. So I can write department extends college, and this office extends college. So I will write office extends college, and the CSE extends department, and mechanical also extends department. So CSE extends department, mechanical extends department. So I will write some logic like public void get name of college, or like get name. So I can put string name of the college, like that. So I can print something. So the name of the college is plus name, like that. So I can put in department also. So get, I can put department name, like that. then in office I can put some different method like get office timings like that. So I can put the hour in number of hours. The number of hours in which the office will work is NOH. Then in the department, I will put some thing like get HOD name like that. So string name, the HOD department, head department name. Then again, we can have the get HOD name like that. So now what I can do is I can have three possible inheritance, like one, I can get the result of CSE, then I can get the result of MEC, then I can get the result of office. To get the result of CSE, I need to create the object for CSE. To get the result of MEC, I can create the object for MEC. To get the office thing, I have to create the object for office. I can call. So when I create the object for CSE, I can call the methods inside CSE, then department, then college. Similarly for mechanical, I can create object. If I create object, I can get the objects, or I can get the properties of MEC, department and college. Similarly for office, I can get it for office and college. So I'll do that here. So the first scenario is for CSE. So what I will do is I will create an object for CSE. CSE C is equal to new CSE. So when I do that, what I can get is I can get this get HOD name. I can get C dot get HOD name. You can put the name of the HOD like that. CSE HOD. Then I can get the department name. So the department name I can get with the help of get department name. So the department name is CSE, like that. And I can get also the get name of the college. C dot name of the college. Maybe you can put Anna University. So this is for CSE. We'll get the CSE HOD name, then department CSE, then you'll get the college. Similarly, you can do it for MEC. So you can do it for MEC. So MEC. M is equal to new MEC. So m dot get HOD name, m dot get department name, then m dot get thing. So MEC HOD, then mechanical, like that. So this is for MEC. Okay. Now we can have another kind of inheritance for the office also. So I can put office. O is equal to new office. Then O dot. So in the office, you can take get office timings. Maybe like 8 hour. Then O dot get name of the college. So now I will save this as hierarchical demo.java. So I can compile it. So the name is hier demo.java. Then Java hier demo. So now when I call the CSE object, we'll get this three result. If I call the mechanical object, we'll get the three result. If I call the office object, we'll get this two result. So this is said to be an hierarchical inheritance. And in hierarchical inheritance, like, we can have a hierarchical relationship between, or a tree relationship between, and inside the hierarchical we can have a multi-level also. Consider this case, it's a multi-level, like the kind of thing we can do it in multi-level inheritance. Okay, so any doubt in multi-level inheritance? So we'll just take some few minutes for that. Any doubt in multi-level inheritance? Maybe any doubt in multi-level? Sorry, any doubt in hierarchical and multi-level? Any doubts? Okay. So now what we'll do is we'll go for the next inheritance called hybrid. So hybrid is nothing but what I can do is I can this is like a hierarchical inheritance. What I can do is I can include some more inheritance, like suppose I have a single inheritance with me, for the college I have like other university. So other university, like the university that have a tie-up with this college, maybe like the university with the MOU signed. So assume this is a single inheritance and we have a hierarchical inheritance. If we combine both, for example, if I connect this one, then it is said to be like a hybrid inheritance. Combining more than one inheritance is said to be a hierarchical inheritance. Suppose if I combine this way, will it be possible to execute this program? You can put it in chat. If I combine this way, like this, will it be possible to execute this kind of inheritance? Can put it in chat. What happens if I do a this kind of hybrid thing, and what I will get if I run this? Assuming we have other as base class 1 and college as base class 2, and we have a MOU signed as the derived class, which can take base class 1 and base class 2, and this kind of thing will provide an error, because the reason is multiple inheritance is not supported in Java, so this won't work. So when you go for a hybrid inheritance, we have to consider that the fact that it should not have any combination, like when you take any combination, it should not have any multiple inheritance formation. If you have a multiple inheritance formation, then the hybrid will not work. But you can combine like single, multi-level hierarchical without making any like formation of multiple inheritance. Okay, so officially, like, we can say that in Java we can have a single inheritance, then multi-level inheritance, then we have a hierarchical inheritance. Okay, any doubt?